you don't want to get frustrated about palliative care, then measure your program in decades. If you try to measure it month by month, how well you're doing, or even from 1 year to the next, you're probably going to get frustrated because the government didn't give you the money you needed for whatever. But I've often said, look back 10 years. What were you doing then, and what are you doing today? And then you'll probably be quite satisfied that there's been progress in palliative care. If we look decade by decade, there's been phenomenal growth. Almost all health authorities, health regions now in Canada, it's mandated by the provincial governments that they must provide end-of-life or palliative care programs. They must have a degree of equity in terms of policies and guidelines within their regions. That's tremendous. In British Columbia, if I go back 10 years, that wasn't there, right? But today it is. So, but I've been 30 years in British Columbia, so it took 3 decades for provincial and federal policies to move into place. The dollars and the programs to carry it out sufficiently still lag behind. So if you look at surveys by Senator Sharon Carstairs, who did kind of every 5 years kind of a checkup on palliative care in Canada, or if you look at the Canadian Hospice Palliative Care Association, you know, they'll quote that, you know, 20 years ago, you know, 5% of the population had access to palliative care. Whereas now, in their more recent reports, you'll see it to be 30 or 40%. And in some regions, it'll even be higher than that. So there's been, you know, a significant expansion and progress of the field, but yet there's a long ways to go. Not only for today, but we keep, as you know, all the economists and politicians, everybody is looking for the aging population and the baby boomers getting older, and all the projections of the increase in deaths that are going to occur in all diseases, cancer, renal failure, heart disease, etc. And most of them will range between 30 and 40% increase, you know, by, you know, in another 2 decades, it'll be that high. So we keep measuring in decades, and it's going up, but it'll be that high. And so we're struggling now to provide the dollars to ensure comfortable care for people. So the issue is not going to go away. It will become more critical as time goes on.